that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first believed. My chains are gone, set free. My God, my Savior has ransomed me. And like a flood, His mercy rains, unending love, amazing grace. Promise good to me, His word, my hope secure. He will my shield and portion me as long as life endures.
Mama, to do the right things, so now you have to let your baby fly. You've given me everything that I will need to make it through this crazy thing called life. And I think I found the answer to your prayer. He's never gone.
Welcome, family, friends, and loved ones. We gather here today to celebrate the marriage of Brooke and BJ. You have come to share this commitment that they have to one another, and we ask for your love, support with this union, and allow Brooke and BJ to start their married lives together with the people that they care most for. We're going to have Eric lead us in a meditation before we get started.
Everybody want to take a seat, maybe? What a cool day. Thanks for being here. Brooke and BJ asked if I would maybe assist in this way, which is that I think all of us had a lot to get here, right? Are we wearing the right things? Have we said the right stuff? And did we leave the coffee pot on at home? What are they going to serve at the reception? And I hope the chicken's not dry. Whatever it is, right? And we get so caught in our thoughts. and I think the intention was just to try to get here and to get present. So if anybody wants to join me, close your eyes. Just take a really deep breath. Max the lungs totally out. And then push out everything that's in there. Do that a couple times. Let's forget about everything that's ever happened up until now. Just check it all at the door. Forget about everything that's going to happen later. And just agree with ourselves that for the next couple of hours, we're just going to be here. As we come into right now, let's just pay attention to our breath. Just notice as oxygen enters our bodies and carbon dioxide leaves, and we have this relationship with the world we live in. And as thoughts arise, just bring our awareness back to the breath. As we do that, let's just relax into this space. Let go of that wrinkle in the brow. You don't need it. Unclench the jaw. Let the tongue rest in the palate of the mouth. Relax the shoulders. Let the arms just fall from the sides like flags from a pole. Relax the spine and the belly. Just let it roll out on the floor. Nobody's looking. Notice your weight on your seat. Notice the cool air on your skin. The sounds. Traffic, my voice, people around you. Light as it comes through your eyelids. And just come back to the breath. And just come back to the breath. You could open your eyes. Thank you.
Marriage, perhaps, is the greatest and most challenging adventure of human relationships. No ceremony can create your marriage. Only you guys can do that. Through love, through patience, dedication, perseverance, through talking and listening, helping and supporting, and believing in each other. Through tenderness and laughter, through learning and forgiving, and learning to appreciate each other's differences. And by learning to make the more important things last in your life, and let go of the rest. With this ceremony, what it will do is affirm the choice that you make as you stand here together, as partners, as teammates, and in life. So I've been asked by Brooke and BJ to honor their parents for the wonderful lives they have given them and the everlasting love that they've shown. It's from them that they have learned the true meaning of love, friendship, family, and specifically for the mothers, this is for you. Lori, Brooke wanted me to say to you, Mom, you taught me to laugh when life is falling apart, to be full of life, and that there's always a plan A, B, C, and preferably F. You taught me that girlfriends are the secret to life and to leave a little sparkle wherever I go. Donna, BJ wanted me to say this to you. Mom, you showed me strength through your integrity. Your compassion taught me to love unconditionally and to honor your family, for they are the ones by your side forever. We've come to the point in the ceremony where you're able to say your vows to one another. But before we do, I ask you to remember that love, which is rooted in faith, trust, and acceptance, will be the foundation of a deepening relationship. No other ties are more tender, no other vows are more sacred than those that you're about to assume today. If you're able to keep these vows, not because of civic law, but out of desire to love and be loved by one another without limitations, then your life will have joy and your home, which a place where you'll find growth, freedom, and responsibility with these vows that you have.
Thank you. Oh, you're gonna hold it? Okay. My love, my brightest light. In the early days, and even sometimes today, I was so undeserving. Oh no, we got so far to go. It's okay. It's okay. And yet you were so relentless. I pushed, you pulled, I feared, you calmed. I bled, you repaired. I faltered, you shushed. The vastness of this world consumed me. And yet you still had the audacity to always tell me I was beautiful. And though that was completely plagiarized, it flawlessly speaks my truth with you. I fell in love with your spirit, Bruce Mader, and I couldn't look away. I've fallen in love with you so many different ways, but none of them deeper than the love affair with your spirit. I believe in the simple truth of what we have. My spirit loves your spirit, and that's the end of it. We talk about how radically different we are. Before, two people so dramatically far apart in distance and experience, and yet we found one another through grace and circumstance and that powerful illusion of choice. I want to look at you more, but I didn't memorize these. It just must have been designed that way. So by choice or fate or luck, I'm not sure, I choose you to be my husband and my very best friend. I promise to be true to you. I promise to encourage your dreams and watch in awe as you kick ass and take names. I also promise to be your unrelenting cheerleader when it's getting handed to you. I promise to believe in your talent and remind you of it on the days you forget. I pledge to not take things too seriously. I pledge to be the soft to your tough and the loud to your soft-spoken. I pledge to keep listening to you with an open mind, because perhaps some days I could be wrong. I vow to laugh through life with you. I vow through the pressures of the present and the uncertainties of the future to believe you on the second or third or fourth time that you tell me we're gonna be all right. I vow to always admire your huge, strong, kind, determined heart and to keep growing ungracefully together. And since your words have always been the ones that I love, I couldn't help but rely on them for my last promise. I promise to take your bad, to be your life when it's messy or unfabulous or really, really hard. And so before God and our extremely intimate group of family and friends, I choose you. I did, I do, and I always will.
I love you, baby.
Love you too.
I take you for the magic that you hold in your heart. I vow to spend my life cultivating my love and care for you and for our family. Our relationship is a most important consideration in my heart. It gives me strength. I pledge to put every effort into strengthening it through honesty, faithfulness, and patience. I promise to spend each day working to become a more true version of myself so that I can serve you. You are the gleaming light that shines through the dark clouds. You are my sense of peace. You are my sense of security. You are my sense of home. You give me the true nature of laughter. I promise to take all of you, the good and the not so good. To meet your not so good with compassion and patience and understanding. I don't believe in chance or coincidence. I believe that there are no missing pieces to the whole entire mystery, that all is in perfect working order, that when the universe picked us to meet, it had something great in mind, that undeservedly We had been gifted with the grace to find the true experience of that perfect universe. The give and take, the experience of love. I cannot consider a day without you. I will forever stand by your side and love wherever, whatever you are. Baby, all that I'm really trying to say is that if I had to choose you or the sun, I would be one nocturnal son of a gun, baby. I love you so much.
I love you too.
We come to the point where you will state your intentions to be wed today. Please hold hands. Brooke, do you take BJ to be your partner for life? Do you promise to walk by his side, to love, to honor, encourage, in all that he does? Will you share his laughter, his tears, and be his best friend? Do you take him as your lawfully wedded husband as long as you shall live?
Totes. I do.
DJ, do you take Brooke to be your partner for life? Do you promise to walk by her side, to love, to honor, and to encourage in all that she does? Will you share with her the laughter, the tears, and be her best friend? Do you take her as your lawfully wedded wife as long as you both shall live?
I do.
We're now going to exchange rings, but before we do that, the rings that you receive this day are the symbols of the endless love in which you enter as husband and wife. Such love has no beginning, it has no end, no giver, no receiver. Each a giver and a receiver, the rings will be a sign of that love and substance, as well as the soul, of the past and the present. Despite its occasional sorrows, love is a circle of happiness, wonder, and delight. Take his left hand. Yes. Brooke, if you would, repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a visible and constant symbol.
As a visible and constant symbol.
A promise to be with you.
A promise to be with you.
Through good times and bad.
Through good times and bad.
Through happiness and sadness.
Through happiness and sadness.
Through sickness and in health.
Through sickness and in health.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
I love you.
Love you.
Brooke, I give you this ring.
Brooke, I give you this ring.
As a visible and constant symbol.
As a visible and constant symbol.
A promise to be with you.
I promise to be with you.
Through good times.
Through good times.
And bad times.
And bad times.
Through happiness.
Through happiness.
And sadness.
And sadness.
Through sickness and in health.
Through sickness and in health.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
Brooke and BJ, having witnessed your vows for marriage, along with all who are assembled here today, by the authority under the power invested in me, I pronounce you husband and wife. You can kiss your bride. It is now my pleasure to introduce for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Mader.
No, gentlemen, let's get one more big round of applause. Let's get one more big round of applause. That's right. All right, guys, they're going to head off. They're going to take some pictures.